Welcome back to another Seymour Marine Discovery Center at UC Santa Cruz Creature Feature. This is Kevin, and this time we'll be taking a closer look at bat stars, a favorite of many Seymour Center visitors. At first glance, bat stars might appear simple, with their star-shaped bodies and suction cup tube feet, but not much else. But take a moment to investigate a little bit closer, and you'll notice there's a whole lot going on. These colorful crescent and polygon-shaped plates cover the upper surface of bat stars. Scientists call these hard calcium carbonate plates ossicles. The way these hard plates fit snugly together forms a pattern that might remind you of scales on a reptile or tiles on a roof. It's those movable, bumpy plates that give bat stars their scratchy texture. But what I find fascinating is those same protective plates take on very different shapes when you look on the underside of a bat star. How would you describe the shapes of these plates surrounding the suction cup tube feet on this bat star? You can even spot structural differences in the plates closest to the tube feet compared to the ones further away. Here you can see how the hard plates function to protect the soft tube feet and stomach safely inside the sea star. And when the bat star senses that it's safe, the plates unzip and the tube feet emerge. If we return to the bat star's top side, did you notice the larger round plate near the center of the bat star? This large plate has a very special function in sea stars. In fact, it's so important that scientists have given it its own name, madre porite, which means mother pore. Compare the madre porite to the other bumpy plates surrounding it. What are some differences that catch your attention? Up close like this, its appearance reminds me of a brain. Those wavy lines are pores, openings where seawater can be pulled inside the sea star's body. The sea star squeezes the water once it's inside its body to power its tube feet and change the shape of its body. One thing that many people don't know is that bat stars have sensory structures concentrated at the tip of each arm. You may have noticed the smaller tube feet that keep waving around in the water. Experiments show those tube feet can taste the water for food and even predators. Did you notice the red dot tucked among the tube feet? That's actually an eye spot a bat star uses to sense light and dark. Now that's really cool. One thing that marine scientists are trying to understand is why some sea stars develop a disease called sea star wasting syndrome. I think you can appreciate just how incredible marine creatures are, especially when you take the time to look a little closer. If you want to learn even more about bat stars and build your own bat star model, visit us at our website, seymourcenter.ucsc.edu, and look for our bat star seaside craft. Thanks again for joining us for another cool Seymour Center creature feature. See you next time.